Today, we are looking at the V6 versus the turbo inline 4. We'll look at the pros and cons of each engine from different angles. We'll also see why car makers have been shifting to turbo 4 cylinders, and we'll drive by some of the most powerful cars with turbo 4. So roll up your sleeves and let's get under the hood. If you've seen my video on different engine types, you probably already know the difference between a naturally aspirated 4-cylinder engine and a V6 engine. But how does a turbocharged 4-cylinder engine compare? This is actually an ongoing debate among car enthusiasts. Some say that a turbocharged 4-cylinder is as good, if not better, than a V6. Others say it's not even close, and they believe the V6 wins in every way. So who's right, and why is there the debate? So let's dive in. First, let's recall how turbocharged engines work. Typically, a naturally aspirated gasoline engine only uses fuel and air that naturally enters the engine to generate power. Its power is generated in a 4-stroke cycle. First, the piston in each cylinder moves downward, sucking in fuel and air. As the piston moves back up, the mixture is pressed against the top of the cylinder where the spark plug is located. Then the spark plug ignites, lighting the mixture of fuel and air, and the small explosion causes the piston to move downward in the 3rd stroke. Then the piston slides up again, pushing the exhaust gases into the exhaust system out of the car. But with the turbocharger, the exhaust gases are directed, so they rotate a small turbine fan located next to the engine. This rotating turbine is used to force more fresh air into the engine cylinder, which results in a larger explosion of power. So what are the pros and cons of a turbocharged inline 4 versus the naturally aspirated V6? The main advantage of a turbocharged inline 4 engine is that it delivers the same power level as a V6, but with much less fuel consumption, space, weight, and price. The turbo I4 is initially less expensive than the V8, regardless of the drivetrain. It also produces less carbon emissions than a V8. But one downside is that the turbo requires a lot of exhaust gas to function properly, and it can take a while for the turbo to initially kick in and do its job. This is what is known as turbo lag. This is why we see many turbocharged Fords with low power output in the lower RPM range. In newer vehicles, turbo lag is kept to a minimum, but it still exists. Turbo engines also tend to lose some power in the high RPM range. The V6, on the other hand, is naturally aspirated and delivers clean and consistent power across the RPM range. The naturally aspirated V6 engine has the advantage of low RPM torque and more power. This is especially important when it comes to towing or hauling, as low-end power is needed to overcome inertia to propel the vehicle. Also, the V6 has more cylinders and a larger displacement, which means more air and therefore bigger explosions. Put that together, you have more power. Also, the V6 does not suffer from turbo lag. On the other hand, the V6 has less fuel economy in comparison. It's also heavier in weight than a turbo 4 and costs more to build. So, which is better, a V6 or a turbocharged inline 4? First, it depends on how deep your pockets are. Some people say stay away from modern turbocharged engines because they require more parts, which means more potential things that can break. Minor maintenance costs can also be higher, and that's because turbo engines run hotter the naturally aspirated engines and may require more oil and spark plug changes. Secondly, it depends on the type of car you want and your driving needs. For example, the turbocharged inline 4 will be more responsive to a lightweight compact car than with a midsize crossover. If you're going to tow a trailer or your family boat, then it's much easily achievable with a V6, whereby typically a turbo 4 won't be able to pull or carry as much. So why have so many automakers started switching from V6 engines to turbocharged 4-cylinder engines? Cooper Erickson says the average consumer doesn't see much difference between the number of cylinders of an engine, but instead really focuses on price, performance, and fuel economy. V6 engines remain common in full-size pickup trucks and large SUVs where more power is required, but the growing popularity of compact SUVs and light pickup trucks also explains the phasing out of V6 engines in cars. In the midsize segment alone, V6 engines make up a dismal 2% of retail sales last year. Guess what its market share was 15 years ago, back in 2005? 35%. So you can see it's taken a nosedive. According to J.D. Powers, among all vehicles, including SUVs and pickups, V6 engines accounted for 27% of retail sales in 2020. You can see the decreasing trend when you consider it used to be 40%. in 2005. Compare that to four-cylinder engines, which took 54% of all retail sales in 2020. That's more than half of the sales. And you can see how it's increased over the years, when you consider it represented only 30% of sales in 2005. In passenger cars, 3 out of 4 passenger cars sold last year had four-cylinder engines. And that's despite the fact that high-performance models make up a large share of the segment. A huge reason for this is because of the Detroit 3, Chevy, Ford, and Chrysler, have discontinued most of their passenger cars. And foreign brands such as Honda and Nissan have simplified their lineups and eliminated the option of a V6 engine in most of their vehicles. Most powerful cars with turbo four-cylinder. But now let's take a ride in some of the most powerful cars with turbo four engine. At the top of the list is the Mercedes AMG CLA 45. This Mercedes is powered by a turbocharged 2-liter inline four-cylinder engine. Its engine optimizes power output to a whopping 416 horsepower and 369 pound-feet of torque. Simply put, this engine is more powerful than most 6-cylinder engines and almost matches the power of a V8 engine. And that's all from a turbo 4. We also have the Ford Mustang. This is a 2.3-liter EcoBoost engine, which is Ford's brand of turbocharged inline 4 engines. Under the hood of this 310 horsepower Mustang with 320 pound-feet of torque sits one of the most efficient 4-cylinder engines ever built. It's also very economical with an average fuel consumption of 30 miles per gallon. The Mitsubishi Lancer Evolution was also one of the most powerful compact sedans of its time. It may have looked small and unassuming, but don't be fooled. It was built for the track. And the Mitsubishi Lancer made a name for itself with a powerful 2-liter turbocharged engine that produced 291 horsepower and an incredible 300 pound-feet of torque. Next up is the Audi S3. It shares the same engine as a Volkswagen Golf R and has the same power output of 292 horsepower and 280 pound-feet of torque. However, the Audi S3 is more efficient than the Golf R in transferring all that power to an all-wheel drive. This gives the S3 the edge in speed as power is sent to all wheels. That's why this car accelerates to 60 miles an hour in less than 4.4 seconds. How's that for speed? And don't forget the Jaguar F-Pace. The car is simply a marvel of power and fuel efficiency in one engine. Its turbocharged 2-liter I-4 just about hits 300 horsepower mark, but it makes up for it with 295 pound-feet of torque. And the additional benefit of this engine is fuel economy. The Jaguar F-Pace averages 22 miles per gallon city and 27 miles per gallon highway. And of course, we also have the all-wheel drive BMW 740e X-Drive performance sedan. This is yet another powerful car with a turbo 4 engine. German automakers are renowned for their craftsmanship and attention to detail. And the X-Drive iPerformance is undoubtedly a popular choice with car buyers because of its powerful engine. While the X-Drive hasn't reached the 300 horsepower class, it nevertheless delivers an impressive 255 horsepower with nearly 300 pound-feet of torque. And who can forget the famous Honda Civic Type R with its infamous turbocharged 2-liter I-4 engine. The engine produced 306 horsepower and 295 pound-feet of torque in a very small vehicle. It also features a highly efficient cooling system to prevent overheating from the turbocharger and heavy combustion in the small 4-cylinder engine. If you haven't seen my video about the marvelous Honda Civic Type R, check it out. But now let's look at a few pickup trucks that have turbocharged the inline 4. The 2021 Chevrolet Silverado and GMC Sierra are powered by a 2.7-liter turbocharged I-4 engine, and these trucks can tow up to 9,600 pounds while getting 23 miles per gallon on the highway. The torque is at 348 pound-feet and peaks at low RPM, like diesel engine, at just 1500 RPMs while keeping the curve flat till 4000 RPM. The Ford Ranger midsize pickup is powered by a turbocharged 2.3 liter EcoBoost I-4 engine with a 10-speed automatic transmission. With 310 pound-feet of torque, this midsize truck can tow 7,500 pounds with a fuel economy of 26 miles per gallon on the highway. But now, you tell me, which do you prefer, a V6 or a turbocharged 4-cylinder, and why? Please join the debate. And if you have any funny or terrifying stories with your V6 or turbo 4, please comment below and share for everyone. If you like this episode, please subscribe to my channel. Thanks for your support.